So another integration problem here of a trig function by first doing a substitution. So in part B, we have the integral of cosecant x times cotangent x times the square root of 1 minus cosecant x. So again, kind of the thing that sticks out to me is, you know, the derivative of cosecant is going to be, well, negative cosecant cotangent. So to me, I'm thinking maybe a u substitution. And I could just pick u to be cosecant, but then I would have the square root of 1 minus u left over. And I still really wouldn't know what to do with that. I think I would actually have to do another substitution. Well, I'm going to include the constant. I mean, if we take the derivative, that goes away in any case. So why not? Let's go ahead and throw it in there. So I'm going to pick u to be the stuff underneath the square root. So our du, well, let's see, we would have negative. The derivative of cosecant is negative cosecant x cotangent x, and then we'll tack on our dx. Well, the two negatives make a positive, so our du actually gives us exactly what we need. So now we can sort of just, you know, rewrite everything again. So let's see, I'm going to rewrite our square root as, you know, to the 1/2 power, and the 1 minus cosecant x, that's what we're calling u, and then we would still have to replace the cosecant cotangent dx, but all of that is just du. So really we're just integrating u to the 1/2 power du. Well, to integrate that, we can add 1. So adding 1, we would have 1/2, so 1 over 2 plus 2 over 2 would give us 3 over 2. And then we divide by 3 over 2, but dividing by 3 over 2 is the same as multiplying by 2 over 3. Plus c, and again, now all we have to do is replace. We've got u, which we said was going to be 1 minus cosecant. That's being raised to the 3 over 2 power, plus c, and now, again, we have found our most general antiderivative of that function.